Victor, Fashion Week, how has it changed? Is there still business being done here? Take us through it.
Well, there's not a tremendous amount of business done actually during Fashion Week. It's an opportunity for us to tell our story, of course, increasingly direct to the consumer, but most importantly to the trade, whether that be fashion publications or digital bloggers who are increasingly telling our story and spreading it across the world, whether that be here in the US or real-time live in Europe and indeed across Asia as well.
Take us through the line. I had a chance to walk around the showroom a little bit. This is very much a different Coach. Season two, I think, of a different Coach. It's very much started probably a year and a half ago.
Yeah, we're now actually in season 4 or 5 of Stuart's runway collections. We're incredibly proud of what Stuart Vevers, our executive creative director, has done in providing the next chapter of the Coach brand. Coach as a credible fashion resource, not just Coach the handbag company, but Coach now a lifestyle brand that provides consumers with opportunities to engage with us through ready-to-wear, especially increasingly outerwear, as well as footwear and other fashion accessories that go into making a whole wardrobe. And Stuart is providing us with his modern take on the Coach woman and Coach man, and how she's living today in the world.
Who is the customer? It seems like the customer may have changed or is changing a little bit just based on some of the designs.
Well, we have a broad customer. She and he are customers increasingly that are fashion engaged, that understand what Coach has stood for in the past in terms of heritage, quality, and craftsmanship, but also understand how we fit within his or her modern lifestyle. So obviously, she can be downtown one moment, uptown the next, and I think Stuart's view of the world increasingly plays with all of the DNA that was originally there, but providing a very, very modern take on it.
You dropped an interesting clue on the last earnings call that the logo, you're seeing a return a little bit to a logo trend. Is that, I saw it a little bit on some of the bags in the showroom, but is the logo back? Do people want to see logos?
We're very excited about the trend. I mean, they say that in fashion, of course, trends come and go and often repeat themselves. In the 2000s, we benefited tremendously, along with many other brands, of course, from what was a very strong period of a branded product and logo product. Brand has always been important, of course. How the brand is expressed through product, whether that be through logo or through pattern or print, is a very important part of establishing an identity. In our case, our signature C has been a very important foundation.
You're taking me back to my college days now.
It has been a very important foundation of the representation of the Coach brand, and we're seeing consumers increasingly re-engage and new consumers coming into the brand who don't know Coach of the past, engaging with us for the first time through Signature C, which is very exciting because it's a very unique and identifiable part of our brand.
What do you think is driving that back? I mean, there was almost a shunning a little bit of a logo, of logos on bags and accessories, but now that's almost like a sea change.
I think it's a reflection of the importance of brand. I think consumers are looking for brands that help them express their individuality, and obviously what the Coach brand represents, what the logo represents in the full story, New York, cool fashion, is reflected most openly through logo product, through branded product. It doesn't necessarily need to be printed logo. It could be through a logo through hardware or a specific pattern. But I think consumers are desirous of expressing their individuality and showing, of course, their connection through the brand much more openly.
Sure. And there's also a trend, if I caught it right, if I read my fashion blog things correctly, mini bags, smaller bags, is that coming in now too?
Yeah, there's been a huge trend, I think, towards cross-body bags, towards smaller bags, and in general, especially as consumers leave wallets behind, and now we're looking for smaller ways, smaller portable bags to carry their iPhone or other accessories that they may have with them, rather than a wallet within a larger bag.
Take us through the Selena Gomez new collection. I believe this is the first one. She's designed a couple bags. What does it mean, and other accessories? What does it mean to have that type of partnership? What, over 125, 126 million Instagram followers? What does that do for the brand?
Phenomenal. Well, first and foremost, those partnerships only work if they're authentic. We're incredibly excited by Selena and what she represents. She's a young American celebrity, incredibly talented, but also incredibly hardworking. and someone who reflects, I think, the diversity and everything that we hold true as well from a values perspective in terms of her belief in hard work, her belief in diversity, very inclusive personality who's has tremendous awareness, as you've stated, through the numbers on her Instagram account, not only here in the US, but globally. So first, that authentic connection is important. And then secondly, of course, a desire for us to share those values globally through product. She and Stuart instantly connected through the design process. They came up with a few items that, in fact, have just launched in the last week or so that we're incredibly excited about and have been very, very pleased with the reaction that we're seeing globally.
And does she have other things planned season, or is it just a one-time collection?
Well, this is the first collection that we're working on. As far as what's ahead, I think to be determined.
I'll follow up on your Instagram account, I guess. Fair enough.